We're asked, which of the following is an equivalent form of the equation of the graph shown in the xy plane, from which the x-intercepts can be identified as constants in the equation? So pause this video and see if you can figure this out. All right, now let's work through this together. So we want to find an equation where if we graph it, we get this parabola right over here, and we want it to be in the form in which or from which the x-intercepts can be identified as constants in the equation. Well, let's look at the x-intercepts here. We have an x-intercept right over here. X-intercepts happen when y is equal to 0, when we intersect the x-axis. So one happens at x equals 2, and then another here happens at x is equal to negative 3. And so when we look at the choices, we are looking for a 2 or a 3, and the first two really don't see that. You aren't able to pick out these x-intercepts easily from choices A or B, so you can rule those out. Now, both choices C and D have some things that deal with 3s and 2s here. And what we have to remember is these are the x values that make y equal to 0. And so when you have it in this factored form, when you have this quadratic here in a factored form, if you have x minus 2, that means that x equals 2 is going to be an x-intercept. How do we know that? Well, if you put a 2 in right over here, 2 minus 2 is 0, 0 times anything is 0. If you put in a negative 3 here, negative 3 plus 3 is going to be 0. So this is actually the choice that we are looking at. Once you factor this quadratic in a form like this, the intercepts are actually going to be the opposite, the negatives of these numbers right over here. So this C right over here was a distractor to say, oh, look, I see a negative 3 and I see a 2. But this is actually a different equation than what we have over here. And you would see here that the x-intercepts would be at x equals 3 and x equals negative 2. Not negative 3 and positive 2. So we'd rule that one out as well.